best wedding present ever. Yeah!
Finally.
You've just beaten Bromley, the double champions, double league champions. Tell us about the game. Because everyone expected a fiery, tough game. So what happened today?
When you think about, they Bromley four times now, and they've got the better of us. I think maybe Bromley would agree as well. Every single time we've played them, we've been the better team. But I think, you know, when you look at players like Jay Knight, Stephen, Theo, Kai, these are efficient, so whenever they get chances, they put it away. So for us, we had to just tweak our tactics up a bit. We actually went 4-4-2 today, so just to make sure that they don't get their joy out wide, because we were expecting Lewis as well. So we changed the tactics up. So I was down to Reza and K, and I think today we actually put in a proper, like, resilient performance. And we did it before in the season against So I think to this season's been about adapting and changing ground, and I think that is a credit to the players, it's a versatile team. So yeah,
I mean, Shah, look, you went one goal down. What were you thinking at that point? Because at that point you're down in the title as well.
No, we've been showing heart all summer league, innit? So like, I knew we was gonna get back into the game at one point. Just took a bit of magic from Cody, and the rest was history. Cody got the goal at the end. So yeah.
We've always said two goals is enough to beat Bromley. Because when you really think about all the games that they've lost this season, they've lost in the last 2-3 years. Two goals, they've never scored more than what Jamie against Shadow last year. They lost, was it 2-1? Ace this year, they lost 2-1. Shadow 4-0. But with us, we scored 3 past them and we scored 4 past them, but we still seem to be on the losing end. But today, I think because we were a bit more defensively resilient, we conceded that one, but we scored 2 and it was enough to win the league. So, you know, I think we get a proper shout out to all of our boys. The new signings, Assam this year he's been tremendous for us. You know, he's come in, and Assam was, you know, where he was being wasted, to be fair, knowing the team and stuff. He's come in at Aberfeldy, and you know, he's been one of our standout players this year. Toib, Kirtley, Cody, Shah, Rocks, Muscle, everyone has done a job. But I think for me, I'm going to give an early prediction: Cody player of the season. I think. Cody's been our man of the season. He's been our go-to guy. I think he's got about 8 goals.
No, that's out. We needed him.
And today, tune into that before the Instagram. You'll see his free kick. Rocking.
Tell us about the free kick. Go on, Rocks, tell us.
So the free kick, normally it was on my side. So normally I would step up to take it, but I was feeling quite generous at the time. So I gave it to Cody, and Cody just lashed up, you know, an absolute screamer. But fair play to Cody, you know, he's been there all season. He got a goal against the Bromley last time around. And to be fair, the last few games we did face Bromley, they've even told us that we were the better team. But it's just, we've always fell short. And it's a testament to Bromley, the team that they are. You know, they can take the crush for 60 minutes in a game, but they always come out on top. And that's the last because of Steven. And they just know how, even the Bangladeshi players, you know, I always hear people like slating them, saying, oh, they're not that good, they're old now. But their know-how is second to none. And, you know, obviously you've got Dip on Mini, Hamid, and all these players. There's a reason why they've been at the top for this long. We've taken the league, and that's the one we've wanted. But for us, we're still not satisfied because we know how good we are. We know we're capable of doing the double, and that's why our ambitions were. But to fall to Bromley in the cup, you know, there's no shame in that. And you know, it is what it is. But now it's about us. We said this season we had to win. Some people forget. We only started 5 years ago, you know. Some of us, you know, we're 24 now. We started when we were 19. Me, Cody, Rox, T, Shah, Abdul, Anam, all of us, we were here when we were 19. So for us to go on for 5 years, people talk about us like we're a household name, like we've been here for 30 years, like your Shad, yours, your New Rocks, and all these other teams. We've completed everything in 5 years. It's over to them now. Because now we got the target on our hands. Let's see how many of them are going to try to take off. Because for us, the climb has just, you know, the climb has just started, because we're at the top now. So now it's about, you know, these teams coming out for us. I know Shadow finished strong this season, so I'm looking forward to them next season. I know Bromley ain't going to, you know, they're not going to just lie down. They're going to come back next season stronger as well. So BYM, they're always in the running. So now, you know, I'm happy for our boys. Rafid, left back, you know, done a terrific job. But we did say in the beginning of the season, how we're going to win this league is if everyone steps up, every single person has their moment. Fortunately for us, Rafid has his moment, Samad, Toib, Rox, Shah. I mean, Rokib's got more goals than me this season, you know. So it just goes to show that, you know what, everyone is doing their part. But for me, Cody, I have to take I'm not going to take my hat off literally, but I have to take my hat off to Cody. You know, Cody's been a stellar performer. If he doesn't, he is 100% player of this season.
Bring Cody, bring Cody. Cody, come here.
You know, before Cody comes, I mean, all I see on the side is a bunch of youngsters watching the game. What are they? Are they family? What is it? Tell us about the family.
Obviously, we've got our youth team coming in there, and our youth team's done they're doing really well. I mean, credit to Russia, who's done a great job, you know, bringing them up. And you know, we just wanted them to come here and watch so that they experience what, you know, these occasions are about. Because even though people might just say Sunday League, but I mean, for some of us, this is the highest level we're going to play. Do you know what I mean? So it's making Sunday League fun. And I think the youth are losing that. When I was 10 years ago, when I was like 14, 15, there was about 10 teams in our league, and it was exciting going there. Now we're having youth teams drop out. We want these youngsters to know that football in grassroots, in our town, in this community, is the most important thing. Come, enjoy yourself, be part of the fan, be part of winning, and you know, experience that.
To be honest, you know what, with league campaigns, you always need luck. That's the truth, you know, no matter what. How many teams, like, you know, for, I don't know, in the last 20 years or however long it's been, you know, a team like Bowman have never won this league.
Yeah. Mm.
And the fact that in the last 20 years, how many teams have gone unbeaten? And it just goes to show, you know, Bromley done it, what, a couple of seasons ago? They went the whole league, they went the whole league unbeaten.
100%
winning record. We are on the verge of doing that as well. I'm not saying we are, but it's just like, who would have thought that it would happen in such a short space of time? So you always need luck. But for us, you know, it starts from the top. You know, Rez, you know, the guy that's taken the helm this season and the last season or so, you know, we got to give massive credit to Rez, because, you know, no one sees what we do behind the scenes, you know, to make sure everyone's here, make sure everyone's doing their part. You know, so much thought process goes behind this. And I'm sure Bromley and all these other teams do the same as well. But we're just hungry. And we knew for us, like I said, we've been saying it year after year. When we started in Division 3, we knew where we would be in 3-4 years' time. We knew we would be here. We knew we would be soaking this all up. And we knew we would be the Premier Division champions.
Apart from today, what was your most important game? And what result was, you know, the key to the winning the title?
There was the Seoul match, there was the Brick Lane, match, the one with Rokun on the penalty right at the end.
10-9, yeah.
Yeah, and then the Ace game even as well.
So, yeah, but I think for us, probably the Seoul game. I think Seoul were probably early contest. I think we looked at the league. It's fun coming to watch all the other teams play, see, you know, scout the other team. I think obviously Seoul were probably the runaway. For us to run away challenges for us, and we just thought they're probably gonna win it. That's what we thought. They'll be our main challenges here. So when we come into that game, we were actually missing Kurt and MK, the two, you know, key players. And we shifted up, changed around our formation, and we played 4-4-2 because players like Ash, Mo, Betterman, these guys are strong out wide, you know what I mean? So we went with two banks of four, and then it was a bit of a smash and grab, and then Shah actually got the winner in probably the last five minutes or so. And it was a great goal. So, and I think that really, for us, that was the turning point. I think we really went on from that game and believed that we could go on to do it. Even the Brick Lane game, you can't even, when we went down to 10 men, we went down to 10 men, and we managed to win that game as well.
People forget that, you know, Summer League is 60 minutes only. You know, there's three games I remember: Brick Lane, Ace, and today. We went 1-0 down. To change it up in the manner, like, you know, within those half an hour, 40, 50 minutes, however long you get, it's hard, it is difficult. And, you know, Ace had a wicked team out there when we played them. You know, they had a couple of midfielders that were just, you know, they were class. Some of the best players we came up against all season. And for us to turn it around, even against Brick Lane, you know, Jeffrey, he was on fire up until that point. He didn't get the goal, but I think Sam got the goal. I remember he got the header. And it's just that Brick Lane had a really strong outfit. And even they tested Bromley as well. They only lost 5-4. So we knew, we were looking at these opposition. We were like, we will not, like, win this league unless we are, like, literally, we're faultless. The fact that we went 1-0 down in all three of those games and we turned it around, it, like I said, is a testament, and it is the luck that you need. You know, Rokib, we got a few penalties, good decisions going our way, Rokib putting them away, Cody scoring, like, you know, today, that free kick, like, how many times do you see that free kick? But to be fair, he does it, like, he's doing it in the big games all the time, but it doesn't come so often. And like I said, it just goes to show the quality that we've got in our ranks. I know today was the most important game of our whole, like, since we started at Aberfeldy, it was the most important game. Going forward, like I said, the chase for us is now on, because we want to stay here for the next 5 years easily.
You know, I think, you know, with Aberfeldy, I think one thing Kay and Reg, we're always trying to plan and go forward and stuff like that.
So I don't want to like ruffle any feathers, but Adil, Raul and Tanvi, make sure you boys are ready for next season.
Already preparing for next season. Well done, boys. Well done.